everybody and welcome back to another tutorial from my Simply Series range of books. Today I'm going to be taking you through the final piece in Simply Gypsy, which is called Gypsy Magic, and I do hope you like it. If you want to know where to get the book from, there'll be a link coming above my head now, or there'll be a direct link in the description bar underneath this video. So if you want to know how to play Gypsy Magic from Simply Gypsy, then please keep watching. So the first thing I'm going to do is start by playing it through for you, and then I'll take you through parts of the music. That one is Gypsy Magic. So there's nothing really particularly technically difficult in this. I think the first thing I'm going to home in for, which is probably what a lot of you are looking at this music on, is probably bar 15, where it starts with all the scales. So this is just going to be a really, really good exercise in scales. And I would say the only thing you need to know is that your second finger for the C's are going to be in a back position. So the first finger goes on its dot as normal, and the second finger is going to be close or jammed in close next to it. So that's where your second finger is going to be for a C. Your second fingers on the E string are going to be in exactly the same place, but the second finger on the D string is going to be stretched because we're in the key of G major, so we've got F sharps in the key signature. So the second fingers are going to be stretched. In other words, third finger goes where it normally goes, and then the second finger is going to be right next door to it. So the second fingers on the E and the A are going to be back, the second fingers on the D and the G, if there was any, would have been in a stretched position, but we don't have any on the G. So I'd say the first part is fairly self-explanatory. There are some open E's and things in there. If you want to use fourth fingers or open E's, that's entirely up to you. I'm just going to take you slowly through bar 15. So second finger back. Second finger back now. Then you're jumping all the way to the E string, so just move the bow across as quickly as you can and carry on. Back. This F is stretched. And then for the E, I would advise you use a fourth finger because you're going to be going. It's just good. Can you hear all that kind of string crossing in the middle? It's not going to be very nice, so I would use a fourth finger. So if your fourth finger's just going to be there on the next string anyway. Stretch for the F. Stretched. A back two. Back two again. Back. So this one is a C natural followed by a C sharp with a second finger, two second fingers. So C natural, slide it for C sharp, and then carry on. So if I just do that a little bit closer up for you. So all I did there was just simply slide. And then that pretty much takes you all the way back to the beginning again, apart from the last two bars where you've just got another little scale. So if I do the last two bars, that's just a nice simple scale with a second finger back in the middle of that. And then, so you've got some double stopping as the last note. So that last note double stopping is easy enough to do if you want to put that in, and it does sound very nice. If you don't want to put that in, it's completely optional, so miss the one underneath it. So don't put the B in, put the G in instead. So what you're going to do is when you've played that first G, your second finger is going to be in a back position, and then all you're going to do on the A string is play a B, which is going to be on the dot, as we know. And the two are going to be sort of, can you see the two? They're not apart, they're crunched in next door to each other. So once I've done that G, that bee neatly finds its position there. So, and then it just pops in, so these two are sort of jammed in next to each other. You see, so it's easy enough to play. But like I said, if you don't want to do the bottom note, if you're not quite sure, then just leave it out to start with. So that's pretty much it with Gypsy Magic. It's more or less self-explanatory. The speed is completely dictated by how fast you want to do those scales. So there we go. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to check in the description bar directly underneath this video. You'll see links to all the other book series. I've got Simply Romantic, Simply Country, Simply Jigs and Reels, and Simply Jazz and Blues. So they'll all be linked under there with all the videos and everything. So don't forget to check those out. Thank you for watching. I really do hope that you enjoyed Simply Gypsy, enjoyed this series of books. So I hope you'll join me for the next series. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you then.